Hi everyone, it's Andrew Whitehouse here, and this week we're talking about the all-important issue of food selectivity. Now we know that food selectivity is a major issue for many families that have a child on the spectrum, and there's considerable evidence now that kids on the spectrum, many of them, have less varied diets due to the food selectivity issue. That of course is not a great thing. The study we've linked to this week sought to understand why do so many kids on the spectrum have food selectivity issues, with a major focus on sensory processing. So the study examined 58 kids on the spectrum and 53 kids without autism. The major finding was that kids on the spectrum had higher levels of oral sensory sensitivities as well as higher levels of food selectivity. But the major finding was that there was a link between these two variables, so that kids that have higher levels of oral sensory sensitivities actually also have higher levels of food selectivity issues. Now you might scratch your head and go, well, that's obvious. Why is that an important finding? And you're probably right on that point. But what this study really says to me is how important it is in looking at oral sensory sensitivities as a treatment target if kids on the spectrum have food selectivity issues. That's something that we always have to keep in mind.